Well, in general, obviously, knowledge is important, and it's good to just know things. I'm going to give you a little bit of history on Halloween itself, but I'm not going to go real deep into it, because what really matters is what's going on right now anyways. A lot of things morph and change over time. So yes, while it's good to know the foundation and how things even started, it's really simple to just look at, well, what's going on right now and what's happening today and determining, is this right or wrong? I mean, anything that's happening today, you should be able to look at the Bible and say, this is right or wrong, without having to know the actual, you know, very inception and beginning of it. People want to go back to, you know, real far on all the inceptions of everything, which really aren't even anything like that anymore today. Now, with Halloween, the word Halloween is just, it's transformed from Hallows Eve, right? Hallows evening was condensed into Halloween, and the word Hallow is from like being sanctified or saints, and that's the Eve, of course, is the day before an actual day. Hallows Eve was the day before All Saints Day, which is a holiday that's celebrated by the Catholic Church as well as many other false so-called Christian denominations. And ultimately, what that day is kind of like a day of the dead for the Catholics. Are you familiar with El Día de los Muertos in the Hispanic culture, Spanish cultures? Well, you've got a Day of the Dead, essentially, for Catholics as well, and that's All Saints Day, which is followed by All Souls Day, and you've got this whole thing, you've got this long history, and I don't want to bore you with all of that stuff, but that's where the word came from. But the celebration of that event, and see, the focus around that is just around dead people, and that's kind of where it started. Now, I'm not against remembrances, right? We remember our Lord Jesus Christ when we partake in the Lord's Supper and we break the bread and we drink the wine, right? And that symbolizes the broken flesh and the poured out blood of Jesus Christ in remembrance unto him. And I don't think there's anything wrong with remembering loved ones or remembering family members that have passed on. Having a remembrance is different, though, than kind of having this big focus on death. And what it is, it's like this perversion, it's this twisting. Just like an example of this would be, you know, the Catholic Church has their crucifixes where they've got the dead Jesus, you know, hanging on a cross. Now, obviously, to many people, you look to the cross as your salvation. That's where Christ, you know, bear the burden, to bear the sins of the world on himself and paid the price and shed his blood. I'm not against the symbolism of a cross that Jesus made for payment, but when you're putting this, you know, the kind of the dead corpse of Jesus Christ, the glory and the hope is in the resurrection of Christ. It's not in the death. It's not in this dead body and where he was bearing the sin. It's in the resurrection. It's the empty tomb, right? That's where the joy is. That's where the hope is. That's where our faith is. It's not just in some dead corpse that's hanging on a cross. It's in a resurrected body.